Thank you. Welcome to the third part of our program. The last part where we part ways with the remains of our brother. This part is very short. I will speak after when the Reverend has spoken. Now we're going to give the Reverend a chance to open with a prayer and do the burial rites. Thank you.
Let's close our eyes in prayer. Father, we want to thank you this morning once more that we have arrived at the resting place of Ntate Allan Soundi. We pray, Modimo wa rona, we have come to do what your word says we should do, to plant his body. As we plant it, we know that on the day of the resurrection, with that assurance that we get from your word, he will rise again, having received a glorious body. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. We're going to allow him to be lowered into the ground with the assurance that I have indicated that we are planting his body. We are putting it on the ground with that assurance that we have from the word of God that when the trumpet sound, he will rise again. As his body is being lowered, I'm going to read from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13 to 18. May we start lowering the body. But I do not want you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who have fallen asleep, lest you sorrow as others who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring him those who sleep in Jesus. For this we say to you, by the words of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord will by no means precede those who are asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven, and with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words.
Oh,
I am going to ask the family, as a sign of goodbye to Ntate Allen, possibly they have flowers or anything to put in and say, this is our last respect that we're giving to you as our brother, as our father. I'm going to allow the music to play on, and after that, as it plays, we'll allow the family to, and we will allow men that can assist us in closing the grave for us. I was told that in some other areas, I don't know which ones, that the women also that have strength are also part of assisting in putting some soil in the grave. So we will not say no. You know, the issues of human rights, of saying we are equal, I think it's now starting to play a role in some of these things that we are doing. Can we have a song, and we will have the family putting flowers into the grave as the last respect to the sound. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Can you hear me?
We're requesting those who were delegated to come and put in the flowers. In the meantime, to put in flowers. Let the music continue.
Can you hear me now?
Thank you. We are just about to wrap up. Ntakombela buti Jabuma Hangi kuri ata ata hi byela kuri loko hi suka la ku humelela yini. And then thereafter I will come and then the reverend will come with benediction.
Thank you. Thank you. I greet you all in the name of the Almighty. I've been requested by Sesintavi and the children to come here and give a vote of thanks. Firstly, I would like to thank the program director for having guided us earlier in the day and helping to conduct the ceremony that we all were part of, such a memorable send-off to our brother, our father, cousin, husband, Dr. Alan Soundy. I would like to thank the priest for all his comforting words and the message that he left us with, which he emphasized should be planted in our hearts and on our minds. I would like also to thank all the speakers, all the people who came to bid farewell to Doc, as I used to address him, and to all the friends, to all the relatives, the late Alan's colleagues. What I've been requested to convey to all of you is that befitting with the send-off, it's that we'll do the traditional washing of hands by going back to where we started at the church. That's where the traditional washing of hands is going to take place. Followed by refreshments. So in short, we all are requested that when we leave here, we all drive back to the church, and that's where the whole thing is going to be finalized. Thank you.
Thank you, Bujabu.
Lastly, I just want to thank you for being a manageable audience. Some other people are very difficult, but you did listen to this voice and you respected everything that was said. Swinga endliwa ntena la ka Saundi. Kambe swi endliwa hinkwaku la mi famba kona. Amashakeni ya n'wina, avanganeni va n'wina, na vatirhi kulobye va n'wina. With those words, I will request the priest to come and give us a benediction, then we go back.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us and forevermore. Amen.
Children.